Hello and welcome to this Bioprocess International Ask the Expert webcast. I'm your host, Leah Rosin, the online editor for Bioprocess International. Before we get started, just a couple of notes. This webcast is being recorded and will be made available for replay in the multimedia section of our website. We have muted the audio lines, but we welcome you to type in your questions for our speaker in the chat window on your screen. After the presentation, we will begin the question and answer portion because this is, after all, Ask the Expert, and I will ask our speaker your questions from the chat window. Your questions in the chat window will only be visible to myself and our speaker. Thank you for joining us today. It is now my pleasure to introduce Professor Francesc Godia.
Thank you, Leah, and thank you, everybody, to joining this short presentation. I will introduce the work that we did on the optimization of two different cell lines according to the supplementation of commercial media using the DOE methodology. And this is a work that was performed in my research group at Universitat Autonoma de Barcelona in Spain. The outline of the talk, mainly I will cover very briefly a slide of introduction on the supplementation of basal media for cell culture. I will describe the DOE methodology that we have been using in our lab, and then I will present you the results that we got with two different cell lines, as I mentioned before, and getting then down to some conclusions to end up the presentation. So the optimization of animal cell culture can be, as you can see in these slides, can be approached in a very different terms, starting from basal media to the definition of very complete chemically defined and serum-free media. In this case, this the work that we have been performing is taking an in-between approach, and this is starting with some already existing commercial cell media and then supplementing them with specific recombinant proteins to improve cell growth mainly as an optimization function. The approach that we are using for this design of experiment is basically first starting with a kind of proof of concept using a mixture of different of these supplements to have initial estimation that this improvement is realistic. And then we start with the two-step design of experiment approach. The first one is called screening, or also Plackett-Burman design. And this is basically to define what are the most effective supplements in the definition of your cell media. And then we follow up with a second step that is called optimization or Box-Bengen design. And there we define what are the optimal concentration of the selected supplements for our specific study case. So this approach, we have been using it systematically, as I mentioned, with two different cell lines. The first one was HEK293 cell. This cell was basically producing GAG GFP VLPs, virus-like particles, and we were using transient transfection using polyethylenamine for that. The potential supplements that we work here are summarized here: albumin, transferrin, insulin, and a lipid mixture. The first aspect I would like to point out on that study is that in that case, not always the best media for cell growth, that in this case is shown here in black triangles, is the best media for the transient transfection. As you can observe in the next slide, this media that was the optimal for cell growth was had a very low efficiency for transient transfection. Otherwise, there was media, a media that they had a lower beneficial effect in on cell growth, but a very high effect in transient transfection. And this is why we retain one of these medias, particularly the freestyle media. With that previous selection done, then we move to the Plackett-Burman design. There is a design of experiments where you are using two different cell concentrations with a code minus and plus, low and high code levels. These concentrations basically are selected either from the literature or either from a toxicity test. You can see the ones that we had used in this study that, by the way, is already published in Journal of Biotechnology. And this approach will propose you a whole matrix of experiments to be performed, and out of these experiments you can get what is the effect here represented by a positive slope of the different components. As you can see here, out of the four components we were testing, three of them they were having a more positive effect on the cell growth and the transient transfection, and these are the ones that were retained. With these then three retained components, then we move into the second optimization phase, box banking. There, the matrix of experiments you are using is based on three different codes for each one of the three components that they were retained, and you can see each one of these points represents one of the experiments run as a combination of these different supplements. And out of the realization of the experiments, as a result, it is obtained a statistical polynomial approach where you can see not only the effect of the individual compounds on the objective function, but also the effect of the cross effect between different compounds. And with that, you can build all the surface response curves of your system, and you can end up with an optimal combination of your components. In this case, this was the optimal combination of the components, and finally you can repeat the optimal that it is proposed methodology, by the model, and in this case we were obtaining up to 5 million cells per milliliter. That is a 60% increase in respect to the freestyle media without any supplementation. So we were following exactly the same logic with a CHO cell culture. In this case, the objective function was cell growth. We already defined, we selected a number of animal derivative, chemically defined media, and we follow exactly the same three-step approach. In this case, the proof of concept was quite positive, or showing a window of increase in cell growth for the freestyle CHO medium, and this is the one we selected. We tested, in this case, 8 different compounds in the Plackett-Burman with these two different levels. You can see here, based on our toxicity test, out of these Plackett-Burman experiments, we were able to select three of them as the compounds that they were having a more specific impact on our cell growth, and then finally move to the screening step, where again the three retained components, basically selenium, transferrin, and insulin, they were tested with the three different levels, and you can see again the matrix of experiments that was performed. So out of these experiments, we were again getting our a model, our statistical model, with the cross effects and the individual effects. We could draw our surface curves and finally get the optimal for the three compounds that we were using. And finally, we were then corroborating experimentally the optimal conditions that we define, and basically we validate the optimal in respect to a control, where you can see that once more we were getting an increase in the cell growth to a very high number of cells per milliliter when compared to other medias in batch culture. So finally, as a conclusion, basically what we can say is that with this methodology that I repeat is based on starting from already existing animal derivative component free and commercially available culture media, and then supplementing them with some recombinant components, we were able to increase the performance of cell culture both for HEK293 cells and CHO-S cells, and we found the DOE being a systematic and consistent approach for such a purpose. And I'll just need last finish before we get into the question and answer section by thanking the work of three of my students that they were performing this work, and also the collaboration with Fef Chemicals, a Novo Nordisk company that was supporting this in this study, and Professor Amin Kamen in Montreal for giving us permission to use a HEK293 cell line he developed. So thank you for your attention, and I would now be ready to pick some of your questions.
Thank you, Francesc. The first question we have is, can some of the used supplements have a negative interaction with some of the compounds in the media?
Yes, indeed. And in fact, this is why you can, in both steps, but particularly in the second step, if there is a compound that has a cross effect with another compound, you will see it in the cross effect elements in your model with a negative sign, and then this certainly is something that you can detect, and you can of course then you would discard that particular compound.
Do you know which supplements were inhibiting the transfection process for the HEK cells?
No, this is very difficult to know, because the point, and this is certainly one of the drawbacks of using a commercially available method, but that you don't know what is the composition of these media, then you are a little bit blind in that sense. So this we cannot tell. The only thing we can tell is that out of these four commercial media, two of them were not good at the level, at the point of the transient transfection. And I think I already mentioned that, but it is in the bottom of my slides, but this part of the work was published in Journal of Biotechnology, so it's publicly available.
What's the difference between using response methodology and design of experiments?
Well, I think that it depends on the particular, you know, support and approach that you are used to run in your own lab. In our particular domain, and because of the support we have from our statistical service here in my lab, this is the methodology that we are quite used to follow up and we are comfortable with it.
Can you address the need for orthogonality of test conditions in factorial experiments?
Yes, but not in a short time.
And how did you choose what components to test?
Well, this is based on a literature survey, and basically, as you see, most of them are quite, typical compounds that they have been described previously because of, you know, a given physiological effect, like protecting the cells, like supporting oxygen transport in the cell by protecting the membranes of the cells, etc. So it's by the evidence and the study of other already published reports in the literature that then we select, reduced number of components to be used as supplement. Yeah, indeed, there is a follow-up question to that one, and this is: are those media we are testing already having a certain amount of some of these components we are testing? Yeah, and the answer to that question is that we really don't know. For some of them, some of the vendors, some of the suppliers, they are providing us a little bit of information, but as you know, these media are proprietary and it's very difficult to know, it is impossible to know the precise information.
Okay, well, thank you. I think that is the time we have today. There were a couple questions that we didn't get to. We will pass those questions along to our speaker and he can get back to you individually by email.
Okay.
Thank you again for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.